Hello, I'm Loig Allain with Siemens PLM Software. Today we will discuss on the LMS Sysdm syndication feature. This is a feature that has to be activated on one hand on the server side, and we will see how this is to be done. And on the other hand, that has to be fine-tuned by the user upon his own preferences at the client side. Let us first look at the settings at the server side. So, what we see right now on the screen is the server settings window for the Sysdm server. Within the syndication tab, you have the opportunity to define your own server host path. So here is my smtp.com, and it has to be associated with the port that you want this SMTP service to use, here the 25. Finally, you will have to decide which email address will appear as being the sender of all the mails. Ultimately, don't forget to enable the syndication, of course. Once this is done, you can save the syndication settings and you will have to restart the server. Let us now look at how the user will set up its own preferences within the system. So the very first thing that any Sysdm user has to do when facing the client is to log. It is used to the role-based access control server. So my ID here is that one. The password has been already entered and I will simply log in. Once I have selected my workspace, I can now enter the Sysdm infrastructure, and you will see in the upper right corner that you now have, since the release 15 of LMS Imagine.Lab, a bunch of new capabilities such as edit syndication settings and get my mails. We'll see how the user will first define the settings that he wants to apply to get its own information per mail. So it is all about customization of the nature of the information and the frequency by which it is being sent to you. So you can get the usual behavior of the syndication setting, which is about getting an email instantaneously, meaning that anytime an action is being performed on the server, either by you or by one of your peers, you will get an email within your mailbox. Or you can have it sent later on a regular basis. Would it be hourly, daily, weekly, or monthly? It is all up to you to decide how and how much you want to be informed. You can also select the on-demand temporization, which basically will wait for you to ask this email to be sent to you. Finally, next to those temporization options, you have the sort options. This is nothing but defining how you want the information to be structured within the email you will receive. It can be sorted according to the type of actions or according to the time, which will present you the actions in some kind of diary. Let's have them sorted with respect to the actions and apply those settings. Let's now look at what would be actually the kind of email you will receive. I have here prepared a very simple collection that I will publish. It is to enable a collection. So those are the traditional type of information that we have to enter. First publication of my demo collection in this case. And then I will publish. So the syndication is nothing but an email that you will receive on a regular basis within your direct mailbox. Let us now open this mailbox. You see, it appears directly in my mailbox, this new message that is informing me that as a user, this guy, so namely me in this case, has created a collection, which name is Simple Collection. It was created on June the 23rd of the year 2016 at this time. Quite conveniently, I could have had many more informations available within that email. As a summary, what we've seen today is how the Sysdm server has to be configured to enable the syndication service on one hand, and on the other hand, how the user will actually customize the way it will receive the email, either by the frequency on demand, instantaneously or on a regular basis, and how he wants this information to be exposed to him. I'd like to thank you for watching this and strongly invite you to consult our website.